Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. This interview segment is typically about business, about the economy, about demographic trends, but also about human interest from time to time, and that's what it is this time. I was on the platform at the Granite State College graduation at Meadowbrook Pavilion in Guilford this past weekend as the college president, Todd Leach, handed out diplomas, but I was struck by the achievement of my guest, who gave the remarks for the graduating class. This student from Rochester, who was unable to walk earlier in her life because of a debilitating disease, was receiving a degree in engineering psychology with a 3.97 grade point average and had achieved what she once thought was the unachievable. Listen to this short soundbite from her remarks.
I asked anyone who would listen if there was a school out there that didn't discriminate against class, wealth, physical limitations, was close to home, and most importantly, affordable. Initial responses made me think that what I was looking for was a far-reaching pipe dream. As it turned out, when I got down to my actual search, it was remarkably easy. The Granite State College Rochester campus happened to be a mile and a half from my house. Destiny, right?
And with me is the young woman who spoke those words, Kimberly Hallett. Welcome, Kimberly.
Thank you.
Nice to have you here.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
And the president of Granite State College, interim chancellor of the University System of New Hampshire, Todd Leach. Welcome.
Thank you, Fred.
Nice to have you.
Great to be
here. Your president. You hit rock bottom when you were a young woman. Before you ever went to college, you couldn't walk, and you were homeschooled. How did you, what was rock bottom, and how did you get out of it?
Well, rock bottom for me was when I was 21, and they told me that my prognosis with my disability, the Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, was that I would be in a wheelchair by the time I was 30. And also, I was also struggling with PTSD at the time because of a traumatic childhood. So at that time, there was just such a feeling of worthlessness and helplessness and hopelessness that I was really struggling with that I needed to get out of it.
What turned you around?
Actually, part of what turned me around was receiving medical from the state and food stamps, and I felt like New Hampshire was making an investment in me, and on my part, I owed it to them to better myself to the most of my ability.
And you're from Rochester, so you went a few blocks away to Granite State College office, and what happened?
I told my advisor that the only way I can go to school, because I had such a negative prognosis, was I needed my college to be paid for. If I had $50,000 in a student loan, I potentially couldn't pay that back if I'm in a wheelchair or bedbound. So between the affordability of Granite State, between the Pell Grant and, at the time, the university system scholarship, before they had their funding cut, they were able to cover the vast majority of
President Leach, Todd, as I like to call you, this is about access. Let's put a graphic up on the screen. Access, and this is from the educationweek.org. Cost is the largest barrier to access to college, social disadvantages, lack of academic preparedness, and changes in federal and state financial aid programs. How do we get around access problems like that?
Well, access has never been more important, and I think it's important for all colleges to rethink some of what they do for the non-traditional student. The workforce is changing greatly, the student population is changing, and for us at Granite State College, access means providing affordability, and that's something we do by focus on teaching and learning, and we also use a great deal of innovation to try to bring the cost down, bend the cost curve, keep it low and affordable. But it's also about providing support for students who are coming from different backgrounds and different experiences, and it's about convenience. And as Kim mentioned, going to Rochester was convenient for her. Granite State College, part of the state system.
All over the state.
We have 10 different locations across the state where we offer courses, and we have every one of our degrees 100% online as well.
Real quick, in about 10 seconds, Kimberly, what would you like to do next with your life?
I'd like to get a job and possibly go on to graduate school and do more with ergonomics and human factors, engineering psychology.
Engineering psychology, that was your major. Kimberly Hallett, 2013 graduate of Granite State College, thank you.
Thank you.
And Todd Leach, president of Granite State College and interim chancellor of the university system, thank you.
Thank you, Fred.
And if you want to listen to Kimberly again and hear this interview, you can go to WMUR.com, WMUR.com, let me say it clearly, and click on News and then click on Project Economy.